Hello guys, welcome to Dr. Duchanya Fitness, and today's topic is menstruation related myths in India and strategies for combating it. So guys, various myths related to menstruation in our country, these myths are going to be very harmful if we are not using proper strategies to combat these myths and taboos in our society. So please spread the awareness related to menstruation hygiene. And please like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you guys. Thanks a lot. Hello guys, welcome to Dr. Duchanya Fitness, and as a topic of menstruation related myths in India and a strategy for combating it. So menstruation is a phenomenon unique to girls. However, it has always been surrounded by taboos and myths that exclude women from many aspects of social culture life. In India, the topic has been a taboo until date. Such taboos also menstruation present in many societies impact on girls and women's emotional state, mentality and lifestyle, most importantly their health. So these taboos are going to impact on girls and women's emotional state, mentality, lifestyle, and most importantly their health. The challenge of addressing the social cultural taboos and belief in menstruation is further compounded by the low girls' knowledge level, understanding of puberty, menstruation and reproductive health. Thus, this is a need to follow a strategic approach to combat these issues. So we need a strategic approach to combat all these issues related to menstruation, because of these taboos, women or girls in our society are facing various health, lifestyle, mental and health related issues. It is a natural process that first occur in girls, usually at the time of puberty, that is 11 to 14 years. Is one of the indicators of the onset of puberty among them. Despite being a phenomenon unique to girls, this has always been surrounded by secrecy and myth in many societies. Taboos surrounding menstruation exclude women and girls from many aspects of social and cultural life. Some of these are helpful, but others are potentially harmful indicators for these girls and women. Culturally, in many parts of India, menstruation is considered as dirty and impure. But scientifically, it is known that the actual cause of menstruation is ovulation. It's nothing but a process that is called as ovulation, followed by missed chance of pregnancy that results in bleeding from endometrial vessels. This followed by preparation of next cycle. Therefore, there seem no reasons for this notion to persist that menstruating women are impure. So this notion is totally rubbish. Many girls and women are subject to restriction in their daily lives simply because they are menstruating. Not entering the puja room is the major restriction among urban girls, whereas not entering the kitchen is the main restriction among rural girls during menstruation. So there are different sort of restriction in urban, both in urban and rural areas. And like base for this myth is also the cultural belief of impurity associated with menstruation. It is further believed that menstruating women are unhygienic and unclean. Hence, the food they are prepared or handle can get contaminated. And however, as long as general hygiene measures are taken into account, no scientific test has shown menstruation as the reason for spoiling of any food making. So menstruation is not going to spoil your food, guys. Such taboos about menstruation present in many societies impact on girls and women's emotional state, mentality and lifestyle, and most importantly their health. Large number of girls in many less economically developed countries drop out of school when they being menstruating. So dropout rate is quite high due to menstruation. Over 77% of menstruating girls and women in India use an old cloth, which is often reused. Further, 88% of women in India sometimes resort to use ashes, newspapers, and dried leaves and husk sand to add absorption. This is very bad. That this is totally unhygienic. It can lead to infections, and this is totally unhygienic, guys. The first and foremost strategies in this regard is raising the awareness among the adolescent girls related to menstrual health and hygiene. Young girls often grow up with limited knowledge. They don't have that much knowledge of menstruation because their mothers and other women shy away from discussing the issues with them. Adult women may themselves not be aware of the biological fact or good hygienic practices. Instead, passing on cultural taboos and restrictions to be observed. Mother is going to pass these same cultural taboos on their daughters too. Community-based health education campaign could prove worthwhile in achieving this task. There is also need to spread awareness among the school teachers regarding menstruation so that they can teach this whole process and the taboos related or myth related to menstruation to their students. Women and girls are often excluded from decision making due to their low literacy level per se. And increasing the education status of women play an important role in improving the health status of community at large and overcoming the cultural taboos. In particular, provision of sanitary napkin and adequate facilities for sanitation and washing should be made available with gender perspective. These facilities should be available, and low-cost sanitary napkin can be locally made or distributed, particularly in rural and slum areas. These are the area where access to the product is very, very difficult. That's why these women keep on using those dirty clothes and ashes and all. Men and boys typically know even less, but it is important for them to understand menstruation. Menstruation is nothing but very normal biological phenomenon. Adolescent girl and woman should understand that they have the power of procreation only because of this virtue. They can support their wives, daughter, mother, student, and employee. So men and boys typically should know or must know about the menstruation process and menstruation hygiene. So guys, in our country, our government is doing very well. They are providing sanitary napkins in rural areas under National Health Rural Mission. So please spread the awareness regarding menstruation and menstrual hygiene and prevent these bloody taboos in our country. Thank you, guys.